evening, everybody. Thanks so much, everybody, for your support, for your continued support over the years. I know a lot of you have been coming for many, many years, and it's always fantastic to see everybody. Any newcomers here tonight? All right. I think we got a full house. Great. So it's been a pretty wild year, you know, this year. And we have a pretty wild and crazy show, I think. One of my colleagues mentioned that our show often reflects what's happening with our organization. And so it's been kind of a wild, crazy year, and we're having a wild and crazy show. But everybody's worked really hard, and we usually start this show about 3 months in advance. We started it back in September this year. And everybody's put their heart and soul into it for many weeks. But thank you so much for coming and sharing the spirit of the holidays with us. And I hope you enjoy the show.
This doesn't look like the North Pole. No elves, no snow, no reindeers.
Where are we?
We've gone through time.
Where are we?
Macy's.
We are?
After that burrito fiasco, I'm happy to take a well-deserved vacation.
Me too, boss. There's no better place than in Jamaica for Mexican food.
HCIS agents, Anderson and boss, please report to Hope headquarters immediately.
So much for an extended vacation.
Jack Frost, a nefarious secret agent of Grinch, has been spotted throughout the time continuum.
I hate that guy.
Our sources suspect the Grinch organization is attempting to sabotage Christmas by changing the plots to well-known Christmas movies. We must stop him in order to save the spirit of Christmas before it's too late.
Oh, I love Christmas movies. It's the most wonderful time.
Oh, brother, can't you give me something better to do, like feed these reindeer stalls?
Everyone glowing and people giving you one of a good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Are you gonna break my eardrums over there?
We got your Candy Cane walkie-talkie, reindeer antler decoy, Santa hats, and Jingle Bell super glue. Oh, and your method of transportation, designed by our top engineer at the Christmas tree.
Well, Dick Mills!
Jack Frost is nipping noses all over the holiday universe. Your three assignments are listed on the itinerary. Unless these movies are set right by midnight tonight, Christmas Eve, Santa won't be coming, and every good girl and boy will forget the spirit of Christmas.
Well, I'm sure their parents will appreciate it. Cut it out!
We're gonna use the same heifer jump that Santa uses to go to every house. Pull lever and you'll rocket out of HQ's chimney. Good luck.
Thank you for the assignment, boys. I was ready to go back to my vacation.
Yeah, me too, boss. Where to, boss?
Seems like George Bailey needs help finding the spirit of Christmas.
Geronimo!
Well, hello there.
Happy holidays.
Excuse me, sir, we need to ask you a few favors.
Clarence Stubb at your service.
You see that guy over there? His name is George Bailey. He's about to jump off that bridge.
My life is terrible.
Oh my.
Why, God, why?
You gotta convince him that you're his guardian angel and you gotta set his life straight.
I don't know, gentlemen. It's a little bit strange.
Nobody loves me.
How much money you got, Anderson?
50 bucks.
Here's your 50 bucks.
This is the fortune. I guess I can lie on Christmas.
Christmas is awful.
One more thing.
Help! Help! Help!
So, your name is Clarence, and you're my guardian angel.
Yes, but I have to get back to heaven. So stop jumping on bridge.
Where's your wings?
I have to get my wings after the bells rings.
Whatever.
If I met there, I thought you'd throw me off the river.
I was going to.
Hey!
Next stop, a Christmas story!
Ooh, I'm gonna find you soon.
It'll shoot your eye out. It's super glue. You have to do everything around here?
No, boss.
My dad says your tongue will get stuck to the pole.
I get crazy.
My dad says you're
crazy.
That gives me an idea. Stop eating that reindeer food!
Double dare you.
I not act crazy. You're dead.
Double dare you. I dare you.
Hey.
I quad.
Hold on, hold on.
Triple dare you.
What you got? You got
double
you.
Dog dare you. I dare you. I quadruple dog dare you.
Come on, man. Check it out.
A double dog dare you. A triple dog dare you.
Okay. Hold on, hold on. Hey. Hey.
Hey, we better get out of here before they realize that we're not in grade school.
Has anyone seen Flick? Yes, Esther Jane. Oh my God!
Where to, boss?
Charles Dickens' Christmas classic.
Real Housewives?
No, you nutcracker. A Christmas Carol.
I am Bob Marley, your former partner. I said come to set you straight. You evil shark.
I'm the ghost of Christmas past. You were good in school. You had a girlfriend.
Yeah, I suppose I did. I'm not too bad looking.
I have two bananas.
That's Christmas present. He's a little loopy.
Bah humbug.
I don't think this is working. We should take him to the graveyard from 50 years from now and scare him out of his wits.
Come back to the Christmas tree. What do I say?
Stand there and point. I'll be working the fog machine.
Roger that.
Oh no, Spectre can't yet save my soul.
Oh yeah, sure, boss.
Oh, thank you, Spirit. Our own Christmas in my heart and forever.
Stop hugging the old man. Let's get back to HQ.
You did it!
Yay!
You did it! Good job, agents. Now Christmas is set in order again.
Just one more thing. We weren't able to find Jack Frost anywhere.
Well, about that. Actually, according into the issue with the time continuum, the Christmas movies needed our agency to step in. And to avoid a time paradox, we needed to recreate the exact event. The entire time, it was you guys in those movies.
Wait, it was us in those movies? How come you didn't tell us?
Who's to say it would have been the outcome if we told you?
Oh boy, I'm a famous movie star. I'm gonna start selling my autograph.
Oh, Anderson.
Merry Christmas.
Wait, start over. Ready?
My dad says your tongue gets stuck to the pole.
Okay, what happened? Freddy? What you about, Freddy?
My dad says your tongue will get stuck to the pole.
Okay, I like it, Freddy.
My dad says my tongue, your tongue.
Okay, what is that, Victoria? Huh?
My dad.
I look crazy.
catch you in the in heaven Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe helps to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He he's lugging lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, is this heaven? No. It's hope. It's hope. Give them a nice round of applause. Hey, Javi, what's your favorite team?
Lakers!
Bradley, we're on a first name basis. Bradley? What's your name?
Bradley.
What's my name? God bless you. Bradley and I are on a first name basis. So, on three, because I haven't met all of you, but I have tried. But on three, could you all just say your first name? One, two, three. Don't we feel more like a family now? We're on a first name basis. Mark Twain said, the two greatest days of your life are the day that you were born and the day that you find out why. My beautiful mother, who is 45, is in the audience. She will attest that the day I was born, January 21st, 1959. Any of you who are accountants in the room, I don't want to know what that number is, please. But I will say, the day that I found out why, November 1st, 2016, it was my first day at Hope, and this is why. April Rinnick will play the role of my Vanna White in this group. And yes, thank you. April, I need you to repeat after me. Will the Hope Board of Directors please stand up?
Yep. Will the Hope Board of Directors please stand up?
Give them a nice round of applause. April, we only rehearsed that once. What we didn't rehearse was, I would like you to tell everyone out there what your bowling score was on Wednesday.
A 154.
Oh my goodness. May I ask the audience out here if you could give a dollar for every pin April knocked down, please? Would that work? It is truly a wonderful life for all the reasons that you are here, for all the reasons that we have the opportunity to be embraced by the beautiful spirits that are part of the Hope Center for the Arts. Oh, by the way, did I mention I'm the new CEO of the Hope Center for the Arts? Details. And plus the reason I walk back and forth, there's two. One, I don't want to be targeted. Two, I'm ADD. I can't stand in one place at one time. But That aside is, in a wonderful life, there's a line, every time a bell rings, an angel gets its wings. True? Thank you. You agree. What I have in front of you are angels. They all have a bell on. In the spirit of this evening, the opportunity to get the bells to ring. This is unrehearsed, so I couldn't tell you what this is going to look like, but they are my sales staff. They are all going to just mingle within the crowd over the next 2 to 3 minutes. And whatever you would like to donate to them or on the pledge sheets that you have, if you would just like to write in the pledge sheet whatever dollar amount you want and put bell, if you don't get a bell from them, we will find you a bell because we want all of you to be our angels of hope. So, on your mark, get set, hope, go! Just go be with people out here. So, just go meet anyone. Go take your girl to anyone you want. You want to meet anyone? Just follow your teammates. Okay. If you all want a bell, try to get the attention of the angels.
about the presents.
It's a gift.
Look, there's Santa.
Thank you.
You're in a time war.
Kale, is that you?
You're a puppet?
Everyone's a puppet here. You're in an alternate hope universe.
Oh, no!
If you want to get back on track, you must go see the Lizard of Paws.
Where is that at?
Backstage. Okay, bye.
I guess this is where we're supposed to be.
This will help us get to back to the right hope.
Welcome to the land of Paws.
Who are you?
I'm the holiday angel, of course. This is my assistant, Marissa.
We're here to help you to get back to the universe. You know about hope in the train?
Everybody knows, silly. Just follow that road to the Wizard of Paws, and she'll help you get to where you need to be. Okay, bye.
Hey, wait, aren't you coming with us?
Oh, no, no. I have a lot of angel-y things to do with all these holidays and everything.
She's quite busy. Goodbye. Wait for me.
I guess we bear her that way.
Okay. How much longer, Kathy?
I'm not sure, Marty. Hopefully not long.
Hi, guys.
Who are you?
I'm Slim Shady.
The real Slim Shady?
Yes, I'm the real Shady. Are you going to go see the wizard?
Yeah.
May I come with you? I'm looking for my microphone. I thought the wizard might help me.
Sure. Do you know the way?
Nope. But I have some friends I might. Hey, Challenger, and hey, Heartsy.
Hey there.
Hi, everybody.
Do you want to join us to go see the Wizard of Paws?
Ooh, I've been meaning to ask her for a cat.
Do you know the way?
Yes, she's just the end of this road. At the Temporal City.
The Temporal City?
Don't worry, we'll help you. And I'll get to make new friends along the way.
That's great, thank you.
I guess we better be off. Come on.
Phew, I'm tired.
Me too, let's take a nap.
It's not gonna take long.
I'm sure we have time to lie down for a bit.
What are you doing?
You can't sleep, there's no time.
You've got to go see the wizard so you can get back to Hope in time for the holidays.
Who are you?
No time. Off you go.
Up, up, up.
They'll be fine, right?
Wow! This is the Temple City.
It's so beautiful.
Hot. Who goes there?
Hello, Jack. It's Heartsy. We're here to see the Wizard of Paws.
Hello, Heartsy. How's it going?
Oh, you know, same old, same old. But I made some new friends.
Hello, sir.
They need to go see the wizard to get back to Hope.
It's important.
Yes. The wizard is expecting you. You wait here, I'm gonna go get her.
Presenting the Wizard of Paws, the autographs.
Hello, everybody. No need to be afraid. How can I help?
Go on.
Hi, Uponus.
We were, just wondering if you could help us get back to Hope for the holidays.
Well, you don't want to miss all the great performances.
Of course you don't. I'll help you get back to where you're supposed to be, but you have to do what I tell you.
What do we have to do?
It's easy. Just say, there's no place like Hope, 3 times.
That's it?
That's what she said.
Excuse me, can you help me too? I want to sing, but I lost my microphone.
You don't need a microphone to sing.
I don't?
Nope.
Just think of a happy thought, then open your mouth and let it ring.
Try it.
Long!
Yay!
How about me? I always wanted a cat.
Really? Well, you know I love getting pet and having friends. How about we become friends and you can play with us whenever you want?
That would be great.
How about you?
Thank you, but I just made some wonderful new friends on this adventure. So I don't need anything.
Okay, I guess that's it then. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Remember, say there's no place like hope.
3 times.
I guess this is goodbye. Thanks for all your help.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good luck.
There's no place like hope.
You think they will be okay?
As children we believed the grandest sight to see was something lovely wrapped beneath our tree.
Well, heaven surely knows that packages and bows can never heal a hurting human soul. No.
No more lives torn apart.
is my only life long wish.
This is my promise.
School, I was in an all-girls choir called the Jewels. We had a Christmas concert. My mom was there to watch me and my choir perform. We were phenomenal. All of our voices were in perfect harmony, sopranos, altos, tenors, and bass. I can't remember if my dad was there or not. It was a long time ago. If my dad was in the audience, I know that, like my mom, he was proud of me. My dad also came to my plays when I was in applause. He knew that I had a natural ability for acting. My dad told me that I could be a famous actress if I wanted to, but he advised me to be careful in the showbiz world. It can be cruel. My dad was supportive of my dreams and goals. I know that he would want me to continue to hone my skills and be the best that I can be. Whenever I perform on stage now, I do it not only because I love to perform, but I'm also not doing it for my dad. If he could see me now, he would be just as proud of me. If not, even more so.
because it is my favorite holiday time of the year. I still believe in Santa Claus and I love him because he bought presents and goodies and I'm very good this year. Santa is awesome and nice every Christmas Eve. I bring cookies and milk and carrots for the reindeer. The reindeer are beautiful. And on Christmas Day, I get up and wake my mom up and brush my teeth and she makes hot chocolate for me. We open all the presents and I look into my stocking. After Christmas is over, it's my birthday on December 30th. I get lots of presents and chocolate cake. This is the best birthday ever. Then it'll be 2017. I'm going to see Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales, until May 26, 2017. Pirates of the Caribbean is one of my favorite movies. I love my mom and my family and Santa and hope Santa for the eyes. Thank you.
Oh,
It's great to be back.
What do you think about time travel?
There's no future in it.
Every single day that we have the privilege of having them at our center.
and we'd like to take a moment to bring them up and give them their honor.
Come on, everybody, come on up here.
We're going to introduce them. Thank you, everybody. Mitch Massey, our Chief Executive Officer, come on over.
Lisa Russo, Director of Visual Arts.
Okay. Please raise your hand as we introduce you. Don't be shy. Liz, Para Development Manager. Liz.
This is Lisa. And Erica Melendez. Where is Erica? Where's the man here? Come on, please.
Christine Wampa, Development Coordinator.
Keita Wright, Operations Administrative Assistant.
Sandra Carter, Horticultural and Fiber Arts Instructor.
Alexi L. Conan, Visual Arts Instructor.
Jackie Bell, Ceramics Instructor.
Nora Wolfenden, Music Therapy Services Instructor.
Andrea Tatler, Music Therapy Services Instructor.
Maria Ninos, Dance Movement Therapist. Here's Maria.
Dance Maria. Stephen Noguera, Performing Arts Instructor.
Doris Chang, Music Therapy Instructor.
And out in the audience, joining us tonight, Heather Wright, please stand. Also in the Visual Arts Department, has helped out a lot tonight. Thank you, Heather, for coming. And Diana.
Sat in tonight, no rehearsals, just handling the ball. Tyler.
Brianna and Jamie stepping up. Their aides are wonderful. And thank you for everybody who's contributed. We appreciate you all.
But just one last word is that everybody here has put in a lot of work for this show, but this show would be absolutely nothing if we didn't have an audience. So thank you guys.